Before I get into the presentation, if we're very tight on time tonight, if anybody wants to got anything that we don't cover, you've got questions, just come back to me. You can find me via the website or Twitter, or our number's always on RNS's. So just give me a call. I'm always happy to answer questions, and don't shy away from any subjects. You know, ultimately for us, the business, the shareholders own this business. And it's up to us to engage and tell this story. But I'll move into the presentation. First of all, we've got a disclaimer. I'd encourage everybody to go through that and read it. It's available on our website as well. And a kind of company strategy and Panther Metals. Well, look, ultimately, we're a gold-focused exploration company. Okay, we've got five principal projects. Two of those are in Canada. Two are in Australia. We've got vast networks in both. We're able to draw on those, and we work with them, and we work with all our industry partners. It is quite a remarkable network that I sometimes wish we could show to investors. I come on to this slide. This is a new addition, and you'll understand this slide more later on when I cover some other information. But it shows greenstone belts in our Archean cratons. This is going to be very much a focus of the business going forward. And to give you an indication why, this is a gold endowment on a global scale. And you've got 41% of all known gold in orogenic gold situations. Board of directors, again, I'll cover more of that later on. It's an impressive board. It covers everything you should want and need within an exploration company, right the way through to financial controls, and add geologists on a world scale, and you'll learn more about those shortly. Corporate structure. I'm a major shareholder, and the focus is on keeping control of the shares in issue and the dilution factor within the business. As we look to develop, it's no good to us if we smash this business to pieces on a shares in issue basis. I'm personally looking to increase my own wealth through the growth of this business. So increasing it at a capital level is absolutely paramount to me. And to everybody else. So move on to some of our locations. Canada. Why Canada? Look, the country's built on mining and exploration. It's one of the go-to destinations, quite rightly so, in the world for mining and exploration. And it's a country that's basically built on mining and exploration, and its deposits and its mineralization is second to none, really. And ourselves, we're focused on the Schreiber-Henlow Greenstone Belt. It's where our two projects are. You've got the Big Bear project, and you've got Dotted Lake. We'll move just straight on to the Big Bear project. I'm conscious of time constraints here. Big Bear project, we started off with 12.7 kilometers purchased in September 2018. Since then, we've gradually expanded this through some quite smart deals. We love the area, we love what it's thrown, and we love some of the historic information. This really was a previously fragmented area that we've managed to pull together. Us ourselves have had results of in rock chips of over 100 grams a ton, and some of the gold in soil numbers, they're historic numbers, but to have 18.2 grams a ton just in soils is quite remarkable. And that actually coincides with some of the areas where we've hit some of the high numbers in the rock chips. We've spent a long time in 2020 underground Big Bear. We haven't covered the area yet in its entirety. But to give you some examples, this is the results of the magnetic survey. As a result of this, we did have to purchase more claims, and that's to cover off some of the areas where we've got extremely good results down in the southern section. That happened in September, and it's certainly a high priority for us in 2021, is to really get to understand what's going on there. And as you can see, just from the magnetic survey, we got 39 designated high priority targets, and in total we've got 253 geological anomalies. Now the northern section in on our work program in 2020, we didn't even manage to get there, and this is still an area of extreme interest for us. There's anomalies up there that straight away flashed up during the geophysics survey results, and we're looking forward to getting there in 2021. We have got drill-ready targets at Big Bear now, but unfortunately, we still haven't got our drill permits, but we're looking forward to receiving those at the behest of the authorities. And just to give you an indication of what's going on at Big Bear, you've got the Cook Lake East, Big Duck Creek and Big Duck West. But between those two areas, we actually were the first company ever to find gold anomalies in the soils between them. So that gives you, we're hopeful of finding a system there and linking those into one structure. But you know, that's in the future. But we look forward to receiving those drill permits. We've got Dotted Lake is very much in the Hemlow camp area. Hemlow ground was broken at Hemlow mine in 1985, probably one of the most famous gold producing mines in the world. To date, it's produced something in the region of 22 million ounces, and it's recently just extended its mine life again. We sit to the north of Hemlow. It shows 18 kilometers. It's in the region of 16 to 18 kilometers, but also that area now has seen massive growth over the last 6 months. You've seen really good results to the east from Palladium 1. That's a new discovery. They sit roughly where Olga Lake area is. And then to the west, you've got Generation Mining. They've actually got one of the biggest platinum palladium deposits in North America that's undeveloped. At Dotted Lake, we started off by purchasing 39 cells, and we quickly increased that by adding another 135 to give us a total cell count of 174. And then the reasons start to become clear here. You've got a huge collection of contact zones, and contact zones are really important in exploration, in the discovery of gold and gold deposits. We've been quite ballsy at Dotted Lake. We plan to drill a single drill hole of 400 metres. We know that's going into a gold mineralised shear zone, and we believe that we can go beneath that to get a real understanding of the stratigraphy and understand what's going on underneath the surface along that area. There has only ever been three previous drill holes on the whole property, and the total depth of those was in approximately 500 meters. They really didn't go deep enough. We've managed to confirm the historic gold numbers from the trench at Dotted Lake that we're going to be drilling under as per the results in November. So it's really exciting time, and that's in planning, and we expect to proceed with that reasonably shortly. What's expected at Dotted Lake and Big Bear going forward? We're working on the plans at Big Bear. We're hopeful and we're looking forward to getting the drill permits. Dotted Lake, we've got drilling there in H2 2021. I would actually be very disappointed if it does actually fall over to that long. I expect it to be substantially sooner than that. And it's a planning phase for us over at Big Bear and Dotted Lake, but they're both very exciting properties. Move over to Australia. Australia itself, well, why Australia? I think everybody within the sector and everybody within mining and exploration understands why people are in Australia, and I don't really feel it needs a lot more comments. We'll go on to Marolia Gold Project. We purchased Marolia, or we completed the purchase of Marolia in December 2020. It's a property that really does excite our geologists. If you pay attention to the map here, the bolder outline is the what we've taken as part of the deal with Whitecliffs, and we own the property 100%. And the white outlines, that's we've got an option agreement in place to actually take those properties as well. That runs through to the end of July. We're working really closely with these guys, and we're confident that we can bring that all into one package. That's going to be very significant. You've only got to look at the numbers in the Eastern Goldfields. You know, on this map, you've got Wallaby, 6 million ounces, Sunrise Dam, 8 million. It's everything is there, Granny Smith Freeman. And the predominant gold bearing commercial gold discoveries are made on northwest trending systems. And if you note here, that's exactly what this is. The geologists internally are looking at the geological model. They're confident that they're peeling that back and making some interesting discoveries here. They will be on and are playing that model. But I just highlight some of the areas within Maronia and what really excites us. Some of the numbers that these areas are throwing off, you've got 5 meters at 28 grams, 2 meters at 6.6. You've got some really good numbers at surface in grab samples. You've got 38 grams a ton. And that's just the Burtville East area. You move on to Ironstone. Ironstone's got drilling intercepts here that if we were announced to announce those today, the market would absolutely love them. Yeah, 9 meters at 46.5 grams a ton. You got 4.5 meters at 5.5. And the grab samples are very, very good there. Some of the gold anomalies at surface are good. And this really does need further investigation. It's been drilled, but the drilling campaigns really haven't been that significant. And then you move on to the Comet Well Trend. Comet Well Trend, extraordinary zone. Again, offers real upside here. You've got over 40 ounces of nuggets from surface. You've got a system that's 3.7 kilometers long, 200 meters wide. And you've got in gold anomalies across that entire zone. Now, that hasn't actually been drilled at this stage at any time. So when you start to put the constituent pieces together, it really does add up to a compelling story. When you start adding in the potential on the option agreement, the location, the services available, this whole zone is built for mining and exploration. And there's overcapacity in the production side. So yeah, people are hungry for ore in the Eastern Goldfields now, and they need it to maintain their own businesses. So any improvement here is going to be significant. And we're looking to really jump in on that. And we're confident of a very bright future in the Eastern Goldfields for the company. We'll move on to our other two projects there in the Northern Territory. You've got Marikai and Annaberu. Marikai is a small licensed area, but don't underestimate that. On Marikai, within the Marikai area and just the slightly wider area, including Steve's Hill, you've had over 500 ounces of gold nuggets sourced. You've got rock chip samples up to 50 grams a ton. You've got drill intercepts from surface that includes 9 grams a ton for 2 meters from surface. When we've done a desktop study here, it threw up some really interesting points for us, and we're looking forward to getting on the ground and expanding it. And we've also got Annaberu, the Donkey Hill area. That's the southern section of the Annaberu Dome. The Annaberu Dome is mineralized across it. It's got black silt cover, but despite that, it's the gold anomalies have leached through. Again, very significant. Around the Donkey Hill area, you've got grades at surface 61 and 50 grams a ton. This area was actually discovered by Newmont in about 1992. Once we did our desktop study, it actually completely changed our view of the area. We've got the Annaberu Dome, which you see running to the north out of from the Donkey Hill, but we've got structures on the south, two structures to the south, and we've also got structures to the east. All of those structures within the Northern Territories have a history of gold and commercial gold discoveries. They are completely untouched. So we end up at Annaberu with a project that is four exploration projects in one. And that was a very pleasant surprise for us as a business. We fly Mag at Annaberu and Marakai in February. And then that from that, we'll be able to plan our initial rounds of groundwork. We have done a reconnaissance visit to Annaberu. And there you see with Morolia and Annaberu where we're at. We're planning on flying drone Mag at Morolia as well in February. And we'll be going onto the ground at Morolia doing auger drilling in March. And that's to look at extending the area and the areas of known mineralization. And we'll have, from that will then develop the plans for all three projects on the Australian side. But it's exciting times for us. And I say, why Panther? We've got a clear ethos on what we're doing. We, the team that we've put together, don't underestimate that team. These guys aren't in here just to play. It's not time for them. They haven't got time for that. We're really looking at capital growth and creating something of significance. And what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to go back to our board of directors and just leave that live while I further discuss. And this is taking exceptionally slow. So I'd ask investors what should they expect from Panther Metals? Well, you know, to be in the exploration space and to invest in that, the risk capital is high. So you've got to expect outperformance by the company. And what can we offer I'm going to give up on trying to get back because it is exceptionally slow. But what can we offer as a business? We've got the right locations for gold. We've got a portfolio of underexplored assets that have all got gold or gold anomalies on them. But most importantly, what you've got to focus here is on our geological team. We've got over 100 years of experience. We're an exploration company, but with three geologists of some critical acclaim. And it's unknown largely, but on our Australian subco, you've got Dr. David Groves. And now David supervised over 250 graduates, BSc honours, MSc and PhD, and he's authored or co-authored around 500 publications on economic geology. David's the ex-head of the Australian Geological Society, and he's won many awards. And then you've got Karim Senna. Karim sits on a very small table in London of people that have actually taken grassroots gold projects all the way through to profitable gold production. And that he's one of the most respected geologists on a commercial level, again, on a world stage. And you've got Nick O'Reilly. Nick's been involved around the London mining sector. He understands the commercial aspect. He understands the challenges within mineral exploration and what constraints you've got to be able to do as a junior in the sector. And you add these three together, but then you can put myself here. I've got commercial understanding. I've got market knowledge, but all four of us, we really work tightly together. We're all open-minded. And the focus is on growing Panther. As I've already said, nobody's wasting their time. People are looking to build a business of significance. And at this point, I can introduce, we've been very busy in the background developing a unique model for the company, and that's going to allow for the identification and targeting of orogenic gold deposits in greenstone belts. It's going to enable us to be nimble and quick in our exploration processes. We'll be able to get out onto the ground, and we're going to be able to ascertain in very early times if prospective ground warrants further exploration and further investment. And in key locations, due to the anomalies of the systems in these areas, we're going to be able to do this in an exceptionally cost-effective way. Instead of the traditional model of going for vast land banks, we're actually going to be able to target areas and then define that down that work from small areas, should those results be of what we're expecting and what the model showing us to expect, we're then going to be able to expand that area. The traditional way of going for vast land banks to find a discovery, that's not going to be us. But how are we able to do that? It's because of the team, it's because of the geologists we've got on board. You know, we've got over 100 years of commercial geological understanding, and that gives us this unique USP. It's unobtainable elsewhere. But what does this mean in the real world? It's going to mean you've got a company focused on discoveries in some of the most prospective areas, but in a really cost-efficient manner. And as we focus on gold and gold discoveries, the market really is setting up in a beautiful way for us. We're all witnessing unprecedented quantitative easing, debt and deficit, now negative interest rates. All these things are a positive over the longer term, I strongly believe, for gold in the gold market. But over the coming year, you're going to see exploration across our portfolio. You're going to see corporate developments, okay? We've got to fund this, and that's exactly what we're planning to do. But there may be some surprises within that as we move forward. But it's no point in us smashing up our corporate structure to finance this. We know the market rewards success, so we want success, but we want to make sure that that success isn't you want to jump in, that isn't at the cost of the shareholders. We're looking for the capital growth. So what you're looking at from Panther, just let me finish here, Sarah, you're looking at mag at dotted in February, you're looking at mag at mag results at dotted, that's already been flown, you're looking at mag flight at Maracay and Anabaru, you in Feb, drone mag is happening at Marolia in February. We're putting the finishing touches to the drilling at Dotted Lake, ground exploration planning at Big Bear and Dotted. We've got auger drilling going on at Marolia in March as we seek to extend the gold trends. And we're also in the background working on identification of new gold and new gold targets within the orogenic gold systems in Greenstone Belts. Sarah, over to you.
I tell you what, you've had your porridge this morning, haven't you?
Listen, this is a great business.
Okay, we're on the cusp, allegedly, of a mining super cycle. I'm going back to Big Bear. These are your words. You've just said you haven't covered it in its entirety. So what is keeping you?
There's a combination of factors, actually. COVID has no doubt played an impact on Big Bear. You can't move away from that. First Nations are very, very cautious of people going into areas. I would ask people to look at the impact the Spanish flu had on the native people in Canada. It's not understood in this country, but there really is some shocking statistics around there. So I can totally appreciate why there is a lot of nervousness around that. That's not entirely just totally why, but, you know, it's certainly slowed the processes of getting permits and also getting people out there. We've managed to work on Big Bear all of the summer season of 2020 on the ground, so identify the targets. That work's done, but we still haven't covered the full project. We're really excited to certainly get up to the northern stages, and we're excited to be getting drills on the ground on the targets we've got now.
Okay, you're excited, and at the other side of the world, you've said they're hungry for ore in Oz. You've got an awful lot going on, and right at the beginning, you addressed the potential dilution question, which is you prefer not to dilute, but where is the cash coming from to pay for all this excitement?
What's your space?
Okay, so what are we going to do?
To be fair, actually, Sarah, I should expand on that really a little bit. We don't struggle. People look at us and see what we've raised. We don't struggle for the opportunities to access more cash. Okay. But you've got to make sure. I've got total belief in the gold market and in the precious metals market. The fundamentals are lining up, possibly like they've never lined up in history. And I don't say that lightly. We've never seen what's going on across the globe at the moment in the financial world. But I don't want to dilute this business massively at the levels that we're at. Because as I've said, you look at our geological team, and I really think it's important that people go away and have a look at these guys. They genuinely would not be wasting their time with Panther Metals if they did not see something and feel something of significance. Okay. So if we blow our capital structure and sit on £2 or 3 million now, well, what I'm doing, I'm giving £2 or 3 million out at whatever the price would be today, 14p. How much am I giving away? You know, we want to grow the capital of the business. We want to grow the share price. And everybody wins through the stages. I'd encourage people to have a look at Chris Taylor and what he did with, and what he's continuing to do and what he's done with Great Bear Resources in Canada, TSXV listed company. It really is a great platform. And he's taken them on a hell of a journey.
Okay, so you've put your board and the management team on a bit of a pedestal. Of course, on the board, you have Dr. Kerem Shenna, who's also the chief executive of Ariana Resources. I'm wondering if your fundraising strategy is actually to auction him off, because he is such a rock star within the world that is mining. John Griffiths asks, has Dr. Shenna inspected personally all the prospects? Are his geologist skills proving valuable to your company?
Kerem is a legend. He's I hope he doesn't mind me saying this, but he's actually been, so a lot of the historic core and chip samples from Morolia are stored on a industrial site, and he's been and he's seen those, and he really understands at Barolia what's going on there. Has he been boots on the ground at Anaburu and Marikai? He hasn't, because of travel limitations. However, we have had a long-standing acquaintance who's been on the ground there on our behalf, and he's trusted, and he's actually on the board of another on a company in ASA. On the ASX. This is a guy of some standing in Australia. I'm not going to say his name now, but we're not playing with amateurs. Let's put it like that. So we can trust the information that we're getting from that.
Okay, well, it sounds like a bit of a bromance to me, Darren. But you've got Dr. Shenna on board, and John Griffiths is asking a supplementary question, which is, do you think that the company could have a transformational discovery in the next 12 months?
I'd like to hope so.
You can.
Geology is geology. I'm very, very positive on the projects and the signals that those projects are given. So do I believe this is possible? Absolutely. I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
Okay. Before you even started speaking, Aidan O'Hara had this to say. He said, regarding Morolia, I don't believe the market understands the value of the asset, as it does not reflect in the market cap, in my opinion. What contribution do you believe it should reflect, and what should the market cap be on fair value? Of course, this is the purchase that you made last December, so just last month.
Our job is to prove the market wrong to some extent. And at the moment, I think that the market hasn't really understood Morolia. And that's my job, to educate the market on Morolia. I mentioned there, some of the numbers, and excuse me, but is it 9 meters at 45.6 grams a ton, 46.5? If we was to announce that on that project today as a result of drilling, my question back would be, what response do you think the market would give to that? And I can leave that happily hanging, I believe.
So in the last few minutes, when you were totally excited, you mentioned a model. So you're developing a model.
Models developed.
Okay. Sounds like a strategic overview to me, but what is your USP? I started off by saying we're on the cusp of a mining super cycle. Everybody wants to be prospectors. Everybody wants to be involved in this space. I'm not asking for another accelerator pitch from you, but what is your USP? Just one, the main one.
It's the model that's been developed internally. Because this is from a lifetime of geological understanding. And what that's brought to the table, it's been fascinating to be involved in that process. We will be able to identify, in mining terms, smallish areas. So we can go in there with our team. We'll already know what we're looking for. We'll already know the numbers that we want. And from those results, because of the nature of it in small areas, we can go into multiple areas at a very, very low cost. I'm talking 10, 20 areas. From that, we can then decide from the results we'll get on the ground if we want to expand the area. The traditional way is to take vast areas and go searching because of the mineralization that's going on. We're going to know from the desktop studies what we want to see. Because we can see that, that's giving us the indications. So we're only going to take those areas, then we expand it. So the capital costs and the requirements on the business are a lot less. And that's unique in this industry.
Okay, final question, unfortunately, Darren. Right. Canada, it's a global mine financing hub for miners, junior exploration companies. I know that you only listed on AIM a year ago, but is it time to consider a dual listing in Toronto, for example?
Yeah, correct, there, Sarah. We're on main list.
I beg your pardon. Yes, I did know that because I interviewed you a year ago.
Yeah, so I just for people involved here. So is it time? No. As I've already said, we can get all the financing we require in London. Financing is not a problem to us.
Very good. Darren Hazelwood, Chief Executive of main board listed Panther Metals. Thank you very much indeed. Again, you had a lot more questions, which I wasn't able to field to you. So we will, if you don't mind, be having a follow-up interview with you.
No, please do. And I'll just reiterate what I said at the start. Anybody wants to get in contact with me, please get in contact. You know, it's absolutely imperative. You don't have to be a shareholder to contact me. Come to me. I'm happy to talk Panther Metals. As you've seen tonight, I'll talk it all night long. So let's do it.
There you go. So he might be main board listed, but he still has time to talk to investors and potential investors. Darren, thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thanks, Sarah. Love it.